how dogs, and I like to welcome you back to another exciting episode of Sleeping Dogs, the definitive edition, with all of the added DLC content integrated into the game. So with this, let's go ahead and get started. I'm gonna show you some tips and tricks, give you some tips and tricks in this video, and as well show you a nice special car. Now, as you can see on the map,
how you not
that
crying
exit right here,
wearing clothes like that.
Yes, and here we have a little clothing store. Clothing stores are all over the city area, and only this one you will see has yellowish color to it right here. And this is your clothing store, your premium clothing store for all of the DLC content. Some of it will be played free during missions, like the tactical outfit during cop missions. You don't have to buy this one, costs you 350 grand anyway if you don't have the 40% discount played free.
You know
same
who
thing
Julie
with
is,
all of
right?
these.
I took her to a midnight show once.
This one is good. Should this say in the bottom? Yeah, action hijack vehicles. Can hijack vehicles better with this suit. Every suit, or most of the suits, have their little special abilities, like the Hitman suit right here. You have a reduced police attention. And here the Bronze Warrior suit, which is pretty good to do all of the police bust missions before you go into your safe house with the camera, where you should wear a cop suit in order to gain more percentages and so on. You have a lot of suits right here, others so will have to be played free, like I said, during side missions or missions themselves. Like Triad suit right here is pretty nice, definitely when you do Triad missions, the main missions in green. But for that,
oh,
I have
man in the night market, but you don't buy nothing.
Yeah,
this is going to hurt your reputation almost as much as that shirt you got on.
I like this, the way he talks. Talking about the shirt that I got on, plus the pants and the shoes, this gives you a 15% Triad bonus. If I'm right, there's also a gear, preset gear, that gives you 40% actually. And talking about DLC content and buying, let's go to the garage over here. And voila. You have the regular design, but there's also one from the DLC content, the downloadable content. You have to buy that one in the store right here, the United Front from the game developers of the car. You actually have to go out and buy this car in order to have it in the garage. I do not know where the black police car is at.
I used to drive one of those.
Here's the high roller tuner that came after some racing mission. Same thing with the police vehicles. You have to do the police missions step by step, and the further you get into the story, the more you play free. So you don't get the police missions right away on the map. First, you're starting to have some right here in the North Point. Then comes Central right here. Then you will get some missions in Aberdeen and then in Kennedy Town, in order to play all the goodies free. I'm gonna have a blast with the, now it's over here, with the tanks free ride right here. This is gonna be some super cool mission. But let's first head into the clothing shop. Here's some more blueprint missions. I hope if I pass all of these, I'm gonna get that black police car that looks like a 350Z or a tuned up Skyline. You get it in the very beginning, you have a police mission right here. You get to play it, but you won't get to keep it after the mission in the garage. You can drive it after the mission, but as soon as you save and start a new game or whatever, the car is gone. Still got some Kung Fu stuff here to do. And by the way, I would do these side missions right here. They are really gear up your face points, which you can later on buy cool suits with, like I have on now. So much for the garage, so much for the cars. Talking about spicing things up, spice your police meter up right here in the upgrades. Spice all of the cop upgrades. Get this one down here. Get a weapon from the police car trunks, any police car, and they will give you the shotgun. Oh yeah, isn't that cool? So we don't want to shoot nobody here. Let's take the briefcase for the heck of it. And then take 10 different items in order to beat rival gang members, and you will set free a trophy. Alright guys, now we're in the safe house. Nice, rich safe house, huh? And let's go to the closing gear. But before so, a little hint. Never forget, if you are low on energy and you have a little lust of thirst, then just go to your fridge and fill up your energy meter right there in any of your safe houses. Yeah, just gulp that down. Increase damage, sure. Just go ahead and litter. Now let's go to the clothing over here and check this out. Alright, here's some more preset costumes that you can enable during gameplay. On the bottom left, you can always see the speciality of these suits, what they are good for, what they can do. Some probably say Kill Bill, but it's actually from a Bruce Lee right here. This one looks pretty cool, even so it doesn't do anything as such. That's why I geared my character up with the at least 15% from the regular street clothes that you can get. This one's kind of cool, also Bruce Lee. This one's going to be fun to wear in the Zodiac tournament, which is as well included. You can go to the island before you trigger the tournament itself and then collect the red dragons, because later on it will just ask you if you want to continue or will preset you to the preset you back onto the island if you don't do the tournament, and then you have to wait during the tournament session in order to do the super collect the dragons, which will set free as well some cool powered. I just lost track because of the cool gun right here. Collecting the 10 red dragons from the Zodiac tournament island right here will strengthen some suits, some martial arts suits. Here's the tournament. You can rather trigger the Zodiac tournament from here or just drive directly with the boat through the island, which I did before I had played free the tournament, which takes you almost halfway through the whole game. I'm on 70% right now. And here we have a nice gun. I can't shoot in the house, that sucks. I can't shoot my own house. But you have a little bazooka and a regular gun, so that's pretty cool. Very nice suit, gives you nice protection. But let me just go back to the custom outfits right here. And I have two presets. This one is for the cop missions. So before you go onto the camera right here in your house and do the drug bust, you should gear up on something that really gets your police meter going, so you get more percentage there. Or right here, I have mine for the triad missions, for the main missions in green. I'm on level 10 for the cop missions, but as well, if you do the blueprint missions right here or the single cop missions, which are easy to tell because they both have individual shield, the regular ones plus the DLC pack cop missions, you should change into a cop uniform if you're not on level 10 yet. Here we have the main mission, the green one. So you want to have something triad right there for the young Sung Do Yi. I think Sun Yi Do is an actual real triad gang. They just changed it a little bit, but oh well. Yeah, so let's go ahead and race. Go to the car race right here and then let this awesomeness get some ass whooping. Whatsoever, almost there. Let's go have a look at some more DLC content besides the Stinger bike right here, which is in the racing pack content actually, and it's supposed to give you a racing jacket and a special helmet. I guess I have to do some many more races right here in order to play free that special racing jacket, giving you more bullet protection plus the special.
Wait, I need you to come pick me up. I programmed the destination into your GPS.
Yeah, now this is the special car right here. Whatever you want, press X. You see how it lights up in the back, how it gears up, and then you have this nice EMP. Let me just go ahead, drive over there to the mission. And here you have your nice guns. Ramming upgrade unlocked. And I just had that. Yeah, ramming upgrade. How was that from? Oh, so much to that. Now you can go ahead, that's what I've been talking about with the other cop car, and you can now go ahead and drive around and have your fun in the city with it, but you cannot, it's not in the garage yet, so you will have to do another mission, and as you will see, you will find it nowhere on the card right here. So you will again have to do some side missions or main missions in order to go ahead and play free the last mission. In this case, in my case, in order to get the car into any garage located on the whole map.
Women they were holding in two other locations. This is one of those cases nobody was paying attention to. If you hadn't cracked it, every one of those girls would have been forced into prostitution. Or worse. You've made a real difference, Officer Shen. Thanks.
That's lucky the last I made him human open. Again.
I won't
You're
need
welcome.
You for a while. Keep safe, Wei. And good luck.
So, am I getting anything special now? Case closed. You're in a trophy. Okay. Anything special, like a car finally or something? Don't give me no stupid suit. Supercharged police cruiser, there you go, finally. Took forever to get that thing. It should be that black ride. Let's go check it out. Yeah, happy music. 80 Felix. Whatever. Ah, parking lots all up there. And I'm all down here. Wait a minute. Let's take. Hey, that's just some. Why did the music turn all down quiet all of a sudden? That's so messed up. There you go. Yeah, I helped you turn today, U turn. Make that U turn. There you go.
You have a car here.
I have more than one car in there, trust me. Yes, finally. Beginning of the video, I've been talking about this car. Yeah, you definitely wish every day, not just one day. Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo! Finally! That took forever to get that route. But like I said, this is a DLC ride. And this DLC baby is smacking. Yeah, check this out. Custom tires and everything. This is just one killer. Check. And shotgun. Just giving all of this and let's just get a shotgun in there. Screw you. Get out of my vision. Away. and just get a shotgun in there. That sucks. Anybody want a free shotgun? Better than kid surprise.
What, can I help you?
Go ahead, take it again. Okay. Alright, I got what I wanted. And as you can see, you have to do all of these blueprint missions in order to finally receive this baby. You get to ride it in the beginning and you have to wait till the end in order to get the baby. And this is how it is with all of the DLC content in this game. You have to keep doing missions, side missions, over missions, and you have to go along with the main missions in order to play Frieza more. Side missions, you should do these facial. Those missions right here, those side missions, which give you more face recognition in order so you can buy more suits and some stuff you have to buy. Like, I think it was this car store. No, it was this car store down here where you can then buy that free to download add-on DLC from that little smart mini Mercedes minivan, whatever look-alike car, and a ballista, and so on. So you have to, it's cool how Square Enix built in all the DLC content into the game in order for you to have it. Gotta play it free, but as you can see, you want that police car from the beginning. Same thing with that special police ride that you've seen with the tour, or not police ride, but that special stealth car, whatever you want to call it, with the built-in turrets and everything. That EMP, you have to wait a while in order to get it. And right in order to reach this point right here, I'm almost 70% basically on the main mission, so I have like, I don't know, I think 4 or 5 missions to go until I beat the main story game. But nevertheless, oops, that was a little too far. And then in order to play Nightmare, North Point, or Year of the Snake, where you can also everything in the side missions, you have an extra saving point. It will not oversave your main story. And everything you gain at the end of these missions, like extra costumes, whatever, extra suits, you can then be able to play those, get those in the main mission as well. Alright, this is pretty much it. Thanks for watching. Been a hell of a video and a hell of a time with you guys. I hope you enjoyed. Remember to let me know, what do you like more, Sleeping Dogs or GTA. Hey, I talk to you in the next video. Don't forget to check out my Sleeping Dogs Definitive Edition review on my tech channel, youtube.com/pockethype. And see ya. I'm out, dog.